although they are going to come via the email as well, but I thought I should put it out there so that you guys would prepare your mind, your mental capacity to take what is about to come your way. If you read and you don't understand, ask your PO questions, they will answer. If you don't still understand, ask the program officer in your home country. If you don't still understand, ask me. Hey lovely people, welcome back to the channel. I am delighted for today's video because it is about the Chevening interview outcome, the Chevening application outcome. So welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Couscous, and as a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. Guys, I'm so excited because this is the month or the week that the Chevening interview outcome will be published, and I can't even wait because most of you that are watching me right now are going to become Chevening scholars very soon. So I am really excited for you guys, and I want to say a big congratulations to you because for getting this far, that means you're awesome, you're amazing. Let's not go back to how many people make these applications, okay? You went through the essay applications, you went through the interview, and you are here today. Oh my God, big thumbs up to you. The outcome of the Chevening interview is going to be announced in a very short while, and I thought I should quickly bring you guys this update so that you guys will know everything you have to do once you get that outcome. So stay tuned, don't go away. If you know anybody that needs this video, do well to share it to them and drop your comments in the comment section. Congratulate all of those who are going to make it through the interview. Drop your congratulations because it's not easy. It's not easy. If you made the application, you know what I'm talking about. So please share some love in the comment section. And for those who, for one reason or another, will not be selected, that doesn't mean you're not good enough. It just means that you should try again, because for you to get to the interview level, you are good, man. I have a lot of things to tell you guys, steps to take when you've gotten the outcome, what to expect after the outcome has been announced, and everything like that. It's going to be juicy, it's going to be interesting. So stay tuned, don't go away, and welcome back to the channel. So the outcome of the interview is going to come from Do Not Reply Chevening email. Like, you already have been receiving emails from that address, so by now you should be accustomed to their emails when it comes. And basically you're going to see something like your Chevening application outcome. I already shared in a video my reaction when I saw the outcome of my interview, because I was on the road, I was in transit, and that email came. I didn't even open it, I just saw your Chevening application outcome, and I saw, "Dear Kiseme, we are delighted to inform you." I didn't bother reading the rest of the, why should I read the rest of the email when they are delighted? So they would say something like, "We are delighted to inform you that the selection panel was very impressed with your application and interview." Thing is, the way this email comes, it makes you really feel good about yourself, because they're like, the selection panel was really impressed. Like, and then they're like, and have conditionally selected you for a 2020-2021 Chevening Award. Chevening Awards are prestigious and highly competitive, so congratulations on reaching this stage. So basically, I'm telling you guys now, congratulations on reaching this stage, because you have really tried, you have done everything you have to do, you put in the work, and you're going to get out the best. The outcome of the interview is going to be the point where you are either conditionally selected or on reserve, or you haven't been selected at all. When that email comes, you would be expected to take certain steps depending on your outcome. So if you are conditionally selected, congratulations once again, and listen really well to this video, although they are going to come via the email as well, but I thought I should put it out there so that you guys would prepare your mind, your mental capacity to take what is about to come your way. So let's just go straight to the different things that you'll be expected to do when you have received that email telling you the outcome of your interview. So your program officer will send you an email with the conditional offer and terms and conditions, so that when that email comes, they're going to tell you that, oh, you've been conditionally selected, and your program officer is going to contact you within 1 to 2 weeks. Once you get the outcome of your interview, you are no longer going to be communicating with Do Not Reply Chevening. You're going to be communicating with your program officer, who should make the very first contact to you. So when you get that email, you'll be expected to be patient, because I know you're going to be excited. You're going to have adrenaline rush like we all did. And just be excited to tell your family members that you have been conditionally selected. But take note that this is not the final stage, okay? You are not a Chevening scholar until you get your final award letter. You have been conditionally selected. Of course, I know that once you're conditionally selected, nothing should make you lose that opportunity, because it's a once in a lifetime opportunity. So you wait for your program officer to contact you and send you the conditional selection letter and other documents, maybe your medical form, the terms and conditions that you have to sign. Of course, you already know Chevening terms and conditions now, so they'll send you all those forms for you to sign and tell you what to do. Then they'll also outline to you the conditions that you have to fulfill in order for you to satisfy the conditions on your part. Then you would sign the offer, the terms and the conditions, and you would have to return these documents to them within a stipulated period that they would, you know, specify in the email. Most of the conditions that would be in the conditional letter is going to be something like, you'll give you a deadline to submit at least one unconditional offer from either of the universities that you chose. If you have 3 unconditional offers, that's very good. Go ahead to submit them. But at least at a certain deadline, I think in my time, the deadline was 16 July. By that time, you ought to have met all your outstanding conditions. So talking about the conditions, you know that for your school to give you an unconditional letter, you also have to meet the school's conditions. So if the university that you choose is requesting for an English language test, you have to take that and you have to meet that. So whatever your institution is requesting for you to meet before they give you an unconditional offer, you have to make sure you meet that. I have a video sharing the story of what I went through getting my unconditional offer. So if you haven't watched that video, you should do that so that it will help you, because I had to be really proactive to get my unconditional offer within the stipulated date. The thing is, I had like 5 unconditional offers already from other schools, but I wanted my school in particular as the very first choice, and their conditions were not cheap. Their conditions were not simple or easy, so I had to go through those conditions. So in case you encounter challenges like I did, you need to watch that video. I'm going to probably put it in the description box so that you watch that video and take steps that maybe similar steps that I took that could help you. Not guaranteeing that when you do what I did is going to help her. It's about, you know, the specific circumstances peculiar to you. And do take note that Chevening does not accept courses that, you know, require you to take pre-sessional classes. For instance, if your school says, oh, you need to submit an English language requirement, overall 8.5 in IELTS, and then you have 7 points, and they're like, oh, we are going to allow you to resume school on the condition that you're going to take pre-sessional courses for like 3 months or whatever period, Chevening will not sponsor you for such programs. So you have to look for an alternative option. Maybe go with your second or your third choice. So while you have gotten your unconditional offer and sent it to either your PO or the relevant portal that you're supposed to do, because I know that you know, at a point you're no longer able to access your Chevening portal, but if you had already uploaded your unconditional offers, fine. If you hadn't, they would tell you how to go about submitting all your outstanding documents. When you have gotten all these outstanding documents, you have to now inform your PO, your program officer, these are the universities that you have gotten your offers from, and you have to identify which one is your first choice. Okay, so for instance, I had to inform my PO that Queen Mary University of London is my first choice, and I would love to pick that choice against other ones. So now that information helps your program officer to get in contact with your institution for them to approve your scholarship. Remember that most of the universities in UK have a 20% funding contribution towards the Chevening scholarship. So the essence of you confirming to your PO your first choice is so your PO can get in contact with your university and confirm that they are willing to make their own contributions, that 20% contribution. Last year, because of the peculiarities of COVID, there were some institutions who were unable to sponsor some students or make their own contribution. So the earlier you get back to your PO on your final choices, the better for you. So in case your PO gets in contact with your first choice and whatever happens, maybe if they are not willing to make that contribution, your PO is going to get back to you and probably get in contact with your second choice or your third choice university. And then once your PO has gotten the approval from your university and you have also fulfilled all the conditions on your part, you're going to get an email from your PO saying, "Dear Kiseme, I can confirm that you have met all the conditions on your part. I have also confirmed from your university and I am now in the position to generate your final award letter." Once you get that email, you're a Chevening scholar. Nobody can say otherwise. Once you get that email from your PO, forget it, you made it. So congratulations ahead. Usually your PO creates your final award letter, forwards it to your country embassy or British High Commission, and they are the ones to sign the final award letter and now reach out to you. So in some countries you have to go to the office, to the British High Commission, to pick it up. Other times they can decide to send it to you, depending on your country. They can decide to either post it to you or send it to you through your email. So once you receive your final award letter, like I already said, until you receive your final award letter, you don't have a scholarship, okay? You are still on a conditional selection, which is why you have to do everything possible to ensure that you meet all your conditions. So once you get that your final award letter, you have to forward it to your university. Remember that most universities usually ask for a deposit, and some of you may have already told them that, "Oh, I've applied for Chevening scholarship, I'm not able to pay deposit." So you are updating your university that, "Hey guys, I am now a fully funded scholar and I'm not gonna pay you guys nada." They are now going to update your profile that, "Oh, this person is sponsored." So that's the most important reason you have to send your final award letter to your university. Once the university have received this letter, they are now in a position to generate your CAS. That's your confirmation of acceptance of studies. This is a unique number peculiar to you that is required before you can apply for visa. Remember that for a tier 4 visa, that's an international student visa to study in the UK, it is the university that is sponsoring it. It is not Chevening that is sponsoring your visa. It is your university that is sponsoring your visa. Chevening's responsibility is to give you a final award letter, and you know, you confirm with your university that you have been selected for Chevening, and your university will now generate your confirmation of acceptance of studies for you to now use it to apply for visa. Chevening is not also responsible for applying for visa for you. Neither is your university responsible. The responsibility for you to apply for your visa rests on your head. Apply for your visa is the least of your worries, because once you cross the hurdle of getting your final award letter, then you can do that. The responsibility for your visa is on your head. I'm not saying you're going to pay anything. You're not going to pay any visa fees, because it's going to be waived because you're a Chevening scholar. You are now going to enjoy the benefits. All the benefits that come with it. You know, you're not even going to be spending your money. So, you know, before you apply for your visa, you have to show the evidence of financial capacity, which is going to be your final award letter. And then you have to show the CAS from your university. Once you get those two documents, proceed to TLS website to fill your visa form, you know. Let me know if you guys want me to do a video about visa, the requirements and the rest of it. I guess you guys have everything under control. But let me know in the comment section if you have any questions surrounding visa. Knowing fully well that you did on your own. prone for visa issues. But if at the point of applying for a visa you have any issues, it's okay to contact your program officer at your home country to just get in touch with them to see what they can do, if they can answer any of your questions. Also, for those from Nigeria, I don't know about other countries, but for those from Nigeria, you would have to go for a tuberculosis test, because you needed a negative tuberculosis test certificate before you can apply for your visa. Once you get your final award letter, post it to your university, request for your CAS, and then go for your tuberculosis test. Usually, Chevening would inform you that you should foot these expenses and it will be reimbursed to you when once you arrive in UK. So that's what you're going to do. You know, you've gotten all these documents. It is time to search for accommodation. It is time to make those accommodation choices. I've already made lots of videos about accommodation. Check them out, guys. I am always here for you guys. I used to preempt you guys, so I know what you want. So I make these videos available to you ahead of time. So you go there and check for your accommodation and the rest then. You know what I'm saying? And from there, you would book your visa interview, go for your visa interview if need be. I had a visa interview, but some other of my colleagues didn't, because at a point, you know how 2020 was now, things were just really different. At a certain time, there was no interview for students who wanted TF4 visa in the UK. Once you submitted your application, you were, you know, certain that you were going to get the visa, because it was a challenging time and they really wanted, I think the British government just really wanted to make life easy for students, because things were already very difficult and challenging during COVID. Thereafter, your PO will send you information on how to book your flight from your country to the nearest airport to your university. So basically, look out for that email. The thing is, though, these emails come really well explained, so you should try and as much as possible to make sure that you read all the emails that they send to you, read all the attachments to understand. If you read and you don't understand, ask your PO questions, they will answer. If you don't still understand, ask the program officer in your home country. If you don't still understand, ask me or any other Chevening scholar you know. They're always there to guide you, okay? You are not alone. We don't work alone, although I'm not a Liverpool fan. So then you're going to attend a pre-departure event. There's a pre-departure event that's going to be organized for all selected scholars before you leave your home country. During COVID, some countries' pre-departure events were conducted online, but I was lucky in my country to attend a physical pre-departure event, socially distanced kind of pre-departure event. This is a time where you're going to meet all the Chevening scholars in your country, all the people that were selected from your country. You're going to start your networking at that point, exchanging phone numbers, exchanging contacts. You get to meet the High Commissioner, the British High Commissioner in your home country. You get to meet the program officer, the person that has been interfacing with you throughout the application. Oh my God, pre-departure event is a cool time, because it's going to be the first time that you guys are going to meet and get in contact and begin to develop that relationship. Yes, you will also be asked to download and post your chosen for Chevening plug, because why not? You know all that, I am chosen for Chevening, I am Chevening, that we all posted, okay? You'll be asked to do that, but it's not compulsory, it's optional. Your PO is going to attach it in your email, attach the link for you to download the picture in your email when he or she is sending the final award letter, and you'll be asked to print it and snap your chosen for Chevening picture. Like, why am I so excited as if I'm just being offered this scholarship? I'm as excited as I was back then, guys. And the funny part is that my program is soon finishing, and I asked myself, when did I come to UK? I'm almost like, when did I come to, is it yesterday that I came to UK? And they've already sent me email of how I'm going to book my own departure flight. It's not easy. Once you're able to get your visa, it's time to travel to the UK, and you would be advised that you should try to travel to the UK before your course start date. Basically, the day of your travel is up to you. You're going to choose when you want to travel, and then you speak to the Chevening travel agent, and they are going to book the available flights for you or around that period. Try and reach out to them ahead of time so you have lots of options, okay? Don't wait till like 2-4 days before you want to travel before you book, you get to them, because they have a lot of work to do. They are catering for all the Chevening scholars across the world, and that is not an easy job, okay? Yeah, I think that's everything you need to know, and then you are going to start coming to the UK, and then you're going to arrive in the UK and you're going to be communicating with your program officer. The thing is, before I go, I must say that it is your responsibility to keep the communication going with your university. If you have any issues with your visa, with your CAS, speak to your university. If you have any issues with your conditional selection, with Chevening your final award letter, speak to your program officer. And that's it, guys. Endeavor to try to, you know, get your stuff ready. Let me know if you need a video of what you should pack, what you should come with. I know I did like an unboxing video with the night I arrived in UK, showing you guys how I packed my food. But let me know if you need an updated video of that to guide you. Once again, congratulations, guys. It's not easy to become a Chevening scholar. I'm so excited for you. And if you were not selected this year, trust me, for making it to the interview level, you are amazing. You are wonderful. What I'm going to advise you is look out for other opportunities. Try to apply again to Chevening for the second or third or fourth time, and also look out for other scholarships opportunity that would also fund your studies just like Chevening would do. Yeah, that's it, guys. Do want to give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful to you. Share it. Give me a thumbs up, because I had to urgently make this video because I know that people, a lot of you, would be looking for content like this. I had to quickly go out of my schedule to make this video. Normally I don't make videos today. I'm posting this video tomorrow, guys. Normally I make videos like 2 weeks before, 3 weeks before, but this particular, today is Thursday. Today is 17 and I'm going to be posting this video tomorrow 18. So I'm not gonna sleep this night. Because of that, you guys, please do well to like this video, do well to promote this channel, do well to share it. That's it, guys. Until I come your way in my next video, do take care of yourself and congratulations. And if you have any questions, drop it in the comment section. I'll be here to respond. All right, bye.